Hi, welcome to the eJenn Solutions YouTube channel where we help make your business social media just a little bit easier. Today, we're going to show you how to easily use Meta Business Suite to be efficient, plan, and schedule your social media posts. This is the best thing. I love these options and I hope you, and I know you will love these too. And as always, if you're strapped for time, I have left the chapters for each of the segments in this video in the description below. Feel free to skip around to the parts that you want to see most. All right, let's get going. Okay, so just a few little housekeeping things before we get started. We have three things that I want to make sure that you have set up in order for the next segment to work really well for you. The first thing, of course, is to have a Meta Business Suite account set up. Now, it may sound confusing, but it really is the Facebook Business Suite that has basically changed over to Meta Business Suite. And it actually has a little bit more, it's got a lot more stuff, and I'm very excited. If you need to make sure, if you A, have one set up, or two, you need to have one set up, I included the link in the video description below so that you can easily click that and get started. The second thing you need to do is have an Instagram account that is a business Instagram account. Now, if you have an Instagram account and it was a personal one that you're going to change over to a business, or maybe you were professional, had a professional account, now you need to change it over to business, either way, make sure that the setting or that account is set up as a business account. The third thing is you need to connect your Instagram account to your Facebook page. I like to do this a little bit easier through the Facebook platform versus the Instagram app. So how would you do that with the Facebook platform? Go into your Facebook business page, look at it as an admin. When you see the menu off to the left, scroll down to settings. When you open up settings, scroll down again to the word Instagram. Click that, and there should be all, hit this microphone. There should be all the information that you need to connect your Instagram account to your Facebook business page. Now, if you skipped number two in this list, no worries, because when you get to three, it's going to tell you that you have to switch it over. So that is a little thing that you might want to skip. And just go right to connecting your Instagram account to your Facebook page. It'll walk you through the steps. They make it very easy. All right, so now that you have those three things set up, let's get going to the next part. Okay, so when you come into your Meta Business Suite, your page is going to look something like this. And along the side here, you're going to have a bunch of different options. I would encourage you to come and take a look because there's lots of fun in here. However, for today, what we're going to do is just create a post. Simply click that link. And now this is where you're going to be posting one post, and you can send it out to Facebook and Instagram. So you're doing the work of one action, but you're getting two for one in this. So here's how you do that. You're going to go to post two and use this little drop down box and select Instagram. If you're not seeing your Instagram account, go back to my housekeeping chapter, the foundation and setup, and you will find out why it's not there. The second thing you want to do is come over here, and we're going to add a photo, but you of course could add a video. We do have templates here in Facebook, but I am a big fan of Canva, and of course I am an affiliate, and if you would like to try Canva Pro for 30 days free, you can do so with the link in my description. And the pro version is actually very reasonable for everything that you get. You get tons of stock photos that you can use for commercial license. You get, I believe, all the templates that are in there. So it is actually a really good deal. So I would encourage you to take advantage of the 30 days and see how you like it. I designed this cute little Happy Friday graphic, which is what we're going to use today. So we're going to come back over. I'm going to add that Happy Friday graphic. And I'm going to select the Facebook post size. Now, you don't necessarily have to have two sizes if you're doing, I mean, you know, you used to, but it will automatically take your Facebook post size and transform it into the Instagram size, which is so helpful. You don't have to do it twice, as we've had to do it in the past, or if you're using a different scheduler. You're going to select the Facebook size post. it open, and then that's going to upload, and you can see it here. Now, here's what I like best. I'm going to go ahead and delete this out because, of course, I'm having a little problem with Meta today. However, you get to look at your Facebook news feed preview and your Instagram feed preview. So once you do upload that photo, you should be able to see that preview of the photo as it would look on Instagram and as it would look on Facebook. But for me today, Facebook has decided not to work well, so it is not giving me the Instagram preview. But you can see here I am getting the Facebook preview. And again, if we select it, you'll see that for some reason I'm not getting a preview today. I don't know why, I haven't figured it out, but when that's working, that is actually going to be a really good feature. The second thing we want to do is come over here to post details. This I really love. And why do I love it? Because it allows us to create our post and craft it to the culture of each social site. Facebook posts and intros are way different than Instagram intros. And specifically, it has to do with hashtags. And just kind of the way that you write things for Instagram, you wouldn't necessarily write it for Facebook. So I'm just going to put here, this is a sample post. And we're going to come over here to Instagram and just type away. But here's what I really, really, really like. The hashtags. So again, remember I said Instagram allows you to have more hashtags. You're going to come over here and you're going to have the ability to see what's trending. Of course, you have to search. So I might do social media. And now we see all of these different posts here, hashtags, and we can kind of get an idea of how popular these hashtags are. Now, what I really love is that it has separated the hashtags that are used on Instagram versus the hashtags on Facebook. When you find a hashtag that you like, you have the ability to save it. As you can see, I've saved here for Facebook. Because obviously, that is a lot of posts going on. Sometimes you want to use the higher hashtag, sometimes you don't. It's a whole nother subject. I'll get into it another time. But this, I really like this feature. And when you save it, you can come over here to your saved tab. And as you can see, I saved that social media hashtag here, and it's saved for me. And I think the recent ones it'll show are all the recent ones I have used, which of course is all of these. So this is really helpful and very much time saving because look, boom, 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 you just select it, add it, and it goes right into your post. So if you're using branding hashtags or anything of that nature, oh, isn't that wonderful? Click, 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 boom, in there. You can also use your emojis. The only thing I don't like about this is I can't search, like type in if I'm looking for a star. I have to literally go through and look for the star if I wanted to use that. So a little time consuming on that end, but it's still pretty good. So again, hashtag, you click that. You can do a search for, let's say, bubbles. I don't know, bubble. We can see here we've got a lot of posts on bubbles on Facebook and, of course, bubble on Instagram. So, again, very easy way, great way to make great use of hashtags. I love this. The second thing I love is you'll notice here that if I go to Facebook and Instagram, on Instagram, I can do location, and this will actually post into Instagram for me. And you can see here I'm checking in with this post on Instagram at eJenn Solutions. I can go over here to Facebook and do the same thing. Now let's say I just want to say I'm going I am in Orlando, Florida, I believe. Oops, of course it would help if I spelled correctly. And I can actually tag myself in Orlando City. How awesome is that? That'll go right over. I love it so much. So we're going to take that off. And the second thing I like is the publish now or schedule. We're going to select schedule. And here's the next thing that is going to just make your day so much better and also give you a little bit more, in theory, a little bit more of an organic reach. You have your optimized times. Select that, and now for Facebook and for Instagram, it's going to give you the best times that you should be posting your post. Now, what does best times mean? I'm very excited. Best times or optimal times means that this is when the people who are following you are mostly on the social site. So in theory, if you have the majority of them on social media, that's when you want to post your stuff. When everybody's on social media or on Instagram or on Facebook, boom, you want to get your post out there in front of them. I love this feature. So we have a couple of times here. Now we're doing a Happy Friday, so we're not going to be able to use our optimized times. However, if we were doing it on Instagram, we definitely would want to save that and schedule it in. And it's not letting me save it because it's making me choose a time for Facebook, which is fine. So now I've got these times, I have it scheduled. I simply select schedule. And we're going to see what it looks like. Two posts done with one click of a button, one upload. I can cater to the cultures of both Facebook and Instagram with my post. This is amazing. I love it. This is going to help you with your organic reach. This is going to help you be efficient. And this is going to get you going on your business social media. I'm so excited. If you have any questions, I would love to hear about it in the comments. Or if this helped you, I appreciate a comment, a thumbs up. And of course, I always love subscribers. So I will see you in the next video.
Back in my bag, Flo. Back in my, yeah, yeah, back in my bag, yeah. I'm back in my, yo, yo, I'm back in my bag, yeah. I'm back in my, this is my, back in my bag flow.